The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show.
Hi, from Carlisle, Ohio, this is Les Scamone and Dave on Unscheduled on Armed Radio. And I want to thank the military and all around the world. And especially want to thank our special operators for killing, Abu Baghdadi. Got the number one man and the number two man. They flattened that place. They just turned it into rubble, Dave. As long as there's a Muslim on this earth, fellas, there's going to be terrorists. That's just all there are to it. And don't care who likes it or who don't. That's just how it's going to be. We'll fight this battle until the end of time. Sooner or later, they're going to rise up again and try to do damage to America. But we got the greatest military on the earth, and we'll just take them out. But I want to thank them. Also, today, Army Master Sergeant Matthew Williams received the Congressional Medal of Honor for his bravery at the Battle of Shock Valley in Afghanistan. And congratulations and thank you, sir, for your service and your bravery. And thank all of our military, and keep them and their families in your thoughts and your prayers. And so we appreciate it. We love you. And, it don't make no difference what President Trump does, Dave. They're on him. You know, he's out there. He's giving his report on this, and they're telling him how, and I thought it was pretty cool how they used dogs, and they sicked the dogs on him. Well, either somebody didn't finish the tunnel, or, you know, they thought that would be good enough, because when they run him to the end of the tunnel with the dogs, one dog got injured, he blew himself up, he took three of his children with him. And according to President Trump, he was crying and whimpering like a big baby. And, tell it like it is.
I just wonder how they heard that, though. That's what I was wondering. How they didn't have any microphones in that tunnel. How did they know what he was saying?
I don't know, but, I would say that he got a direct line to somebody, Dave. And eventually...
Because they sent the dog in after him, yeah. And next thing I know, he blew himself up. There wasn't anybody around him. But I just wonder how they knew what he was saying.
I know.
How you know?
They take little parabolic antennas down with them, like they use on the football field so they can listen to football players and stuff.
Yeah, they could have been. We'll see.
It's a directional microphone.
Right.
But they're smaller.
Well, they say there are normally cameras on these dogs, too. And just like on a cop, you know. But they've got it. It's recorded. And so the thing about it is, in time, all that will be released. Just like with Bin Laden, we know who killed Bin Laden. And eventually some of these operators will be declassified where they can talk and come out in the public and tell about it. And they made a big deal, Pelosi and Schumer and all them pukes, made a big deal out of it because he didn't tell them. Oh, you should have told us about it. But he flat told them like it was, Dave. He said, yeah. He said, y'all leaked like a sieve. And Adam Schiff is the biggest liar and leaker in Washington, D.C. And there's no way, that would have threatened their lives if he would have told them about it. And right. He just flat come out and told it like it was, you know. And that brings me to this. First of all, fellas, I've got a report here, as the Rush would say. I just found this out just now. The infamous whistleblower is Democrat Eric Ciaramella, who has close ties to former President Barack Obama. Don't forget that middle name, Hussein. He is also one that helped start the Russia collusion investigation into President Trump 2016. So this is hot off the press. And so now we know who whistleblower number two was.
Now, well, that probably that lieutenant colonel that was under on the stand.
Okay.
Probably told him exactly what happened. And then he's the one that went to Adam Schiff.
Well, here's
my guess.
Yeah. Well, I think that Army Lieutenant Colonel Alexander Xander Vindman, I think, see, he was listening to the phone call, Dave. Okay, so my personal opinion is he is whistleblower number one. He told whistleblower number, however you want to look at it.
He told the other guy.
He told
the CIA guy.
Right, right. But they call him one and two. But anyway, that lieutenant that testified today, he's a Ukrainian, by the way.
Vindman.
Vindman. And I think there's no doubt in my mind, fellas, that his loyalty lies with the Democratic Party. Most of the time, the only reason that you have brass, he's a lieutenant colonel, when they're either at the Pentagon all of them's at the Pentagon, but most of them that go, let me put it this way, most of them that go to the Pentagon, they wind up turning political, all right, and they do choose sides. And in this case, I do believe Army Colonel Alexander, Lieutenant Colonel Alexander Vindman, his loyalty lied with the Obama administration. And that's how I see it. And he's leaked it. He was on the phone call. And he's saying, oh, the transcript President Trump released, it was incorrect. That wasn't everything. And then he goes adding his version to what he said it was in the phone call. Well, I tell you what, a bad military, I don't care if you're an officer down to a buck private, when you go bad, you're no different to me than a bad cop. Okay, and, I have very little feelings for you in that case. And I think that's what we got here is a dirty rat, Lieutenant Colonel Alexander Vindman. And time will tell, David. But he's deep state, boys. He's been in the military for 20 years. Don't know how long he's been up in Washington, D.C., but in my opinion, until I find out different, he's a dirty rat. And if I find out different, then I'll make a public apology. But that's
Jim Jordan said he asked him a question, and then Adam Schiff told him not to answer it.
Exactly. Which he had no right to do.
Right.
He's coaching him. And that
exactly.
Because he would have said, he would have given the name of the whistleblower.
Right.
That's why no pun intended. He told him not to answer.
Right, right. Well, this lieutenant colonel's dirty, boys. That's all there are to it.
And you know what? You made a great comparison there, Les. Like a dirty cop.
Like a dirty cop?
I support the police. Yeah. And anyone that's listening to our show,
right.
Hot Talk, it's on Friday nights at 8 p.m.
There you go.
Knows that I support the cops, but when they go bad.
Right. Right. I always said, Paul, that I always support good policing.
Okay. Right.
Now, the rest of you ought to be in prison. Okay. And, when you got a good cop that won't rat out a bad cop that's violating people's constitutional and civil rights,
he's
one
a
of them's as bad as the other, brother.
Yep. Exactly, by harboring it.
Yep, by not, by his job is to turn in criminals. If your partner's a criminal, you turn him in.
Exactly right. If your partner's a criminal, he's violating people's rights, you turn him in. That's just how it is. And what was I going to say? Somebody help me.
Oh, we were talking about the Lieutenant Colonel.
Yeah, yeah. I had another thought. Okay, yeah, that vote that they're supposed to take Thursday about these rules.
The inquiry.
The inquiries. I made a video Monday, and you mark my words and you see if this vote ain't worth the paper it's written on, because they're not going to go and do formal impeachment proceedings. All this is trying to give the Republicans a little bit of crumbs and them keep their stuff still in secrecy. And one of the Republicans, I seen him, he said, yeah, all they want to do, they want to give the appearance that they're giving us rights to subpoena and to talk to witnesses. However, if they want to subpoena a witness or if they want to question a witness, Dave, they have to have a vote.
I'll tell you what,
on the Democrats for
this whole thing's crazy, because you know? All they have to do is every time the Democrats call somebody in front of their secret outfit there in the basement of the Capitol building,
Sky Chamber.
Lindsey Graham could just recall them over to the Senate Judiciary Committee and let them come before him and answer questions.
He can do that to the witnesses, but he can't do it to, like, Adam Schiff. He can't call him into a Senate committee.
Right. But it doesn't matter if he's got the witnesses. He can just call them over and ask them the questions, and all the stuff will come out.
Will they know who they call?
What they're doing, though, is they're leaking all the stuff that they want out and all the stuff they don't want out, exculpatory evidence they don't want out,
right.
So they
don't
say anything about
that.
That's what they're doing.
Yeah.
And two can play this game. Lindsey Graham has the ability to call them all before the Senate. Just when you get done with the secret chambers, come over to the Senate side.
Dave, but if it's a secret chamber, are they going to let us know who they called?
Well, you know who they called because, the media makes it known who they are.
Well, they show them. They got the cameras on them when they come in the building.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't know.
Yeah.
I was just saying.
They tell their names and they leak what they want to leak, and they tell their names, and that's all you get to hear.
Right.
But Lindsey Graham could call them over to the Senate side.
And the reason he may not do that, Dave, is because he may not want to give them another talking point, like he's obstructing justice or tampering with
he ain't tampering
witnesses.
With witnesses.
Well,
because
we know
it's his committee. And they can't use him for tampering with witnesses.
Well, I hear you, but they will try that.
Adam Schiff is doing. He's tampering with the witnesses.
Yeah. So, but boys, I tell you what, this vote Wednesday, I mean tomorrow, it's not going to be your normal traditional vote to start
Impeachment, exactly. It's an inquiry, and that's all they're going to do is reinforce it as an inquiry.
Right. They just want to give the appearance that they're giving the Republicans some rights, but they're going to vote.
I'll tell you what I'd do if I was a Republican. I'd just let them take their time, because you know what? When it comes time for the trial in the Senate, all those ones who are running for president in the Senate, who's going to be in Iowa about that time, or they're going to be in New Hampshire or South Carolina about that same time, they're going to have to stay in the Senate, and they can't travel on campaign because the trial will be going on, and they have to be present for the trial. So that's going to blow their campaign all to pieces.
Yeah.
That's a good point. Actually, that is a good
point. And I don't think they're thinking that way either, Dave, but you're right.
They have
to
be there.
To think about.
They have no way that they can skip it and go campaign. They can't do it.
Right.
Because all of them have to be present. All the senators have to be present to hear the evidence. And it's because it's such a solemn event, you just can't skip out. But that's the way, if I was a Republican, that's exactly the way I'd try. The way I'd do it.
Just drag it
Make
out.
Make old Bernie Sanders and Pocahontas. And who else? The black guy?
Booker.
Booker?
Yeah.
There's a couple others, too.
Harris
Kamala.
Is
Kamala and what's that other woman?
Buttigieg.
He's a mayor.
He's a mayor, And
there's about six of them,
That's
out of the Senate that's running.
Oh, yeah.
Amy Klobuchar. She'd have
Maybe they'll just change the rules again so they can.
They can't change the rule because it's in the Senate. They don't control the Senate.
Good point.
We control the Senate.
Yep.
Yeah, but now, but we'll see how that goes. And bring up Epstein again here real quick, folks. No doubt in my mind, first of all, this is Armed Radio, folks. Let's Sky Moe and Dave on Unscheduled. Now we got a special guest once again, our producer, Jimmy Bell, and we've got his co-host, Paul Daniels, and joining us. And from Salem, New Hampshire. And so I'm glad to have them. And folks, you can also go to Armed Radio Group News, and we got a whole complete lineup of the show there. And also, I will be sent on Facebook the recorded copy of the Tonight Show. Just look for my marquee on there. Or you can just click on the tape show here on Facebook on my page and get the replay of this. And everybody on Facebook, questions, comments, call us, 1-800-508-5431. I'd love to hear from you. So give us a call. And but now, fellas, Jeffrey Epstein, in my mind, I agree with the medical doctor. I thought this from the get-go. The camera not working. Okay, his cellmate wasn't there. He was left alone for 3 hours. Both guards had fell asleep. They took him off a suicide watch, and supposedly he winds up being hung. I don't think so.
Yeah, the thing is, though, what you have to consider, it had to be one of the guards that choked him out, because the other prisoners are locked up in their cell. He's locked up in his cell. They would have got out of their cell, went and opened his cell.
Yeah.
Choked him out, come back, locked the door, went back in their own cell, locked themselves in.
Yeah.
And in order to do all that, and then risk getting caught.
Right.
So I don't know. It's kind of bizarre, really.
It is bizarre.
Not to mention,
it almost have to be an inside job when one of the guards jail. Jail.
Yeah,
if
right.
they said, "Hey, come here,
right.
go choke this guy out,"
yeah,
you know you're the next to die.
Well, fellas, I think the lawyer's in on it. Epstein's lawyer's in on it. I believe the two guards was paid, and I believe they was the ones that killed him. I can't help but to believe anything
it
else.
Been, it could have been 007, though, because there's Prince Andrew was involved in that, too.
Yeah.
So 007 could have had something to do with it.
Yeah.
He's good at getting in tight places and
doing
it.
Oh, yeah.
Because he does have a license to kill.
Yeah,
so.
Could have been Get Smart, too, might have done it.
Yeah. Would you believe it?
Yeah.
Get Smart.
Agent
86.
Missed it by that much.
Agent 86 and Epstein got 86'd.
Yeah, that's right. He got 86'd. But, you know, all kidding aside, folks, that guy was murdered. In my humble opinion, now his brother. This, Ben's that doctor's report come out. What's his name?
Joe Biden. Michael
Biden. Al Biden, I think it is.
The doctor that was on Fox this morning.
Michael Biden.
Oh, Michael Biden, that's right.
But anyway, see, that will give Epstein's brother a clear avenue to start a lawsuit. Now, with any lawsuit, you have a discovery. And that's where it starts piling up right there, boys.
But the doctor, though, Les, he didn't say it was impossible. He said
right.
he's never seen it before.
In his, what, 50
but
years?
That's not to say,
50 years he's never seen it. So.
It's impossible
right.
for him to have the hyoid
right.
bone broken. Just because the hyoid's broken and there's damage to his thyroid doesn't necessarily mean that somebody had their hands mm-hmm. around his throat. Because the way that the ligature comes around the neck, it can press on at a different angle and cause different trauma. It just depends on the angle.
Well, but because it was broken in three places, there was an excessive amount of force that he felt was more than that could not have been generated just by hanging yourself on the bed. See? And it would have took a snatching, like from a hanging you, you know, dropping you from a hanging platform, you know, where you fall through the floor.
But you get five.
The trap door, yeah.
You get five of those doctors together.
But you do have to remember, a civil suit has a lower threshold of evidence.
All have them look at it. Yeah. And every one of them is going to have a different opinion, probably. That's just the way it is.
But either way, there's enough here to start a formal investigation. And you know how it works. On any kind of a trial, everybody hires experts. You know, mm-hmm. And an expert opinion is just that. It's an expert opinion. Just look at it now. From a legal standpoint and common sense standpoint, that's two different things. But if you just look at it from a common sense standpoint, okay, you know, what's chances of that camera not working?
Three of them.
Guards falling asleep at the same time, both of them. And Epstein took it off his suicide watch as quick as he was. I mean, there's a whole lot of players in this, boys, and it stinks to high heaven, you know what I mean? And there's just too many things there to be coincidence, you know?
Yeah, it's like being eaten by a shark, being struck by lightning while being eaten by a shark.
Right, exactly, yeah, like being struck by lightning and at the same time, you're getting eaten by a shark.
Yeah.
That's a good analogy. Right?
What are the laws? What's the average on that?
What's the average on that?
And like I said, it was three cameras, two in the cell and one in the hallway.
So, say that again.
I said there was three cameras, two in his cell, one in the hallway.
Yeah.
And you got to remember, nobody has been able to commit suicide in this wing in over 40 years.
Yeah.
But one successful suicide.
Yeah. Over 40 years since anybody committed suicide in there.
Coincidence don't happen in jail.
I don't believe in coincidence.
Right. No, to me, that was just an outright murder, and I don't care what they said. I do have good news. You guys remember about the 7-year-old boy, his mom wanted to make him a girl.
Yes.
And nicknamed him Luna and dressed him up. This is there in Dallas, Texas.
Right.
Well, the Attorney General of Texas was about to get involved in this case. And the public scrutiny and outcry they piled it on the court system down there in Dallas. Well, finally, a federal judge come to his senses and give the dad a joint custody. Now, see, he's got a twin brother, but she only wanted to turn the one boy into a girl and wanted to start the procedures to hormone shots and all that stuff.
Right, yeah. Well, 7, right?
Yeah, 7 years old. And the little boy don't want to be a girl. He wants to be a boy. And he's got more sense than his mother does.
Yeah.
And, but anyway, this judge, he stepped up to the plate and give the dad joint custody. And he said the mother cannot do anything medically without the dad's consent. So there's a big win. Praise the Lord for that.
About time, I know.
But now, one thing the judge did do wrong, and this will wind up in a higher court, is he put a gag order on both parents until these kids was 18 years old. Do you believe that?
Can't do that.
No.
Well, I know she was saying that she didn't want him to call him him. I think his name was Jimmy. She goes, she wanted him to call him Luna.
Right,
she wanted the court to force him to do it.
Yeah, right.
The courts can't force language.
Yeah. Why didn't they call a kid Tuna? What, you know,
Luna,
Tuna, it's all the same.
Yeah, I know.
You know, but the poor kid, I mean, he's not the only kid going through this in America today or around the world for that matter. But this is lunacy, boys. This is... This is a mental disorder. This is insanity.
It's the latest from the left.
It is. And it just blows my mind. They will sacrifice their own child on the altar of liberalism, just for the cause, you know. And it's sickening. These people have a mental disorder.
It's become a cult, Les.
It is. It's a cult, a religion to these people.
A sick religion.
You're exactly right. And like you said a long time ago, Paul, that Jimmy, whichever one of you said it, you told me last week, but they want to force you to join them in their delusion.
That's one of Jimmy's favorite lines.
Yeah, I've been saying that for a while.
And I've never heard it put no better than that. That's just plain English right there. And, that's what all this gay gay parade and all this nonsense is. It's to cram this stuff down your throat, indoctrinate your children, condoms in school. I tell you what, they're trying to groom America to accept pedophilia, folks,
That has been the end game for decades.
Exactly. And on top of that, then you got the Muslims trying to push this Sharia law where they can marry these 6, 7, 8-year-old kids. And it works hand in hand. And that both of that crap is in America right now that we have to contend with.
Yep. Oh, you know what? I just want to say this real quick because it does have something to do with what we're talking about.
Yeah.
They have the drag queens reading the kids at the library.
Yeah.
Well, evidently, one forgot to put their underwear on and flashed themselves to preschoolers.
Is that right?
Not one parent complained.
Not one. Oh, man, that's just sickening right there.
Accidents happen.
Yeah. I'm going to plug this one speaker into my headset here, Jimmy, so I can hear you so I can get you on this other speaker.
Power on.
And,
testing 1, 2.
Let's see here. I got you on one. Okay, that goes. Where'd that go? I got a mess here. trying to get this stuff straight where everybody I can do everything for everybody. I just can't hardly figure it out sometimes, boys.
Well, yes, us older generation have such a problem with this.
See, I got you covered on my Facebook. No, you ain't. I just cut you off.
And there he goes, off into the Netherlands.
Oh, boy. I think I got you this time.
Hey, dude, let's just talk amongst ourselves.
All right. I got you now, boys.
All right.
Because, see, I try to run. It's a complicated system.
Yeah, I get it.
But anyway. Here's something else, fellas.
When you were talking about how they're trying to groom, legalize pedophilia, basically. Milo Yiannopoulos talked about that because he was big into the gay rights movement at the beginning.
Yeah.
And when he found out the end game was to legalize pedophilia, that's when he got out.
Yeah. Well, boys, that's what's going on, and it's plain to see. It's very plain to see. And the problem with a lot of people is they turn a blind eye to this stuff. They don't want to get involved. Oh, I don't want to get involved. Bad guys robbing, raping my neighbor. Why didn't you call the law? Oh, I don't want to get involved. I'm just sick of hearing that nonsense.
Well, that's usually in the slums.
Well, I tell you, you get about anywhere, though, anymore. But here's one now, folks. A former top Obama official has agreed to cooperate with Barr's investigation.
Nice.
Boys, James Baker has flipped, boys. Former FBI...
Who's James Baker?
James Baker.
I don't know who he is.
A, He's a former FBI general counsel for the FBI. He was a general counsel for the FBI. James Baker is working with Barr and assisting him in his probe. Barr is investigating the origins of the Mueller investigation to determine if there was any wrongdoing by the Obama administration. Now, Baker was one that it was leaking information that led to the probe against the National Security Advisor, Michael Flynn. So that's going to be thrown out of court, Dave. What do you think about that?
I think Flynn's going to be thrown out of court.
I think so.
Yeah. I think Papadopoulos has got a suit for making him do time.
Absolutely, yeah. I think the same thing. Yeah, it's going to be thrown out, boys.
Which and means Michael Cohen will be, they're all going to be thrown out down the line.
Yeah, yeah. Well, James Baker also leaked information to the Washington Post that ran the story at the behest of the former director of national intelligence, James Clapper. There's another name, Dave, that's going to prison. Brennan, I'm telling you, folks, now that they've got Baker.
I think Brennan's the chief head honcho of this whole thing.
Oh, yeah.
It all originated with him from when he gave the dossier to Harry Reid,
right?
And then Harry Reid told him to disseminate it, throughout all the intelligence agencies. Then remember, McCain got wind of it, and he sent his own guy over to England to get a copy of it, brought it back. Then in January, right before in January of 2017, before Trump was took office, he told Donald Trump about the dossier, and then it made the newspapers, and it came through CNN through Clapper.
Right.
Clapper, who was working for CNN, he spread the news through CNN, brought it out in public, but John McCain already knew about it, and he probably already started disseminating it too. He wasn't as clean as people thought, and that could be why Lindsey Graham doesn't want to get involved in a lot of this, because his buddy John McCain was involved in a lot of it.
Well, and you could be right, Dave. It could be a trail could run straight to John McCain because they was big buddy.
It does,
you know.
It does run through McCain.
And you know,
McCain hated Trump.
Why did he hate him?
He went thumbs down on Trump.
Yeah.
You know why McCain hated Trump? Because McCain trained his whole life to become president and failed.
Yeah.
And then Trump did it as a hobby and won.
It's because McCain was a punk.
Yeah.
He didn't want to fight McCain. He said more bad stuff about Trump than he ever did about Obama when he was running against him.
Boy, ain't
think about that for a second.
Yeah.
He's supposed to be a Republican, and he says more bad stuff about Donald. This is what drives me crazy about Republicans. They badmouth each other, and they won't say anything about Democrats.
Right.
But Democrats, they stick together.
Right.
Just like Trump said, they're vicious.
Right.
And they stay together.
Yeah.
And then what does the Republicans do? They run all different directions.
Yeah.
Look at Romney. He's running off on his own.
Boy.
Oh, Romney, don't stop me on him. Susan Collins and Murkowski.
Yeah.
All three wouldn't sign up for the anti-Trump impeachment.
Right. They're three nuts out of the same daggone shell. And but now, boys, I tell you what, we got enough majority in the Senate where we really don't need them.
Well, they need two-thirds in order to impeach them.
They'd have to lose 19 Republicans for that to happen.
Yeah. Right, like I said, already 50 signed up that they're not going to vote that way.
Right.
Yeah.
50 so far, I think.
Right.
Yeah. And Trump says I never called a one of them.
What's the split on the Senate, Republican to Democrat?
53-47.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. So, now James Clapper, I'm sorry, James Baker, boys, he knows where all the bodies is buried, Dave.
He might. I hope he does.
Yeah.
Well, he's going to give him somebody bigger, and that bigger will get somebody bigger than that.
Well, see, here's the thing.
He's pretty big. He's up pretty high.
Yeah, I know it.
Well, they better get his testimony down quickly.
Yeah.
Because I'll tell you right now. he's going to end up the same way as a lot of other people.
Yeah, like Epstein.
Could exactly. end up dead.
Exactly.
Right, right. And, but now, yeah, he's been involved up to his eyeballs in this. And see, he don't want to suffer the brunt of this, Dave, because he's so high up into this scandal. And he's working on a plea deal, boys. He knows he's going to be indicted. He knows he's going to have to do time.
I think they ought to pick on Lisa Page.
You know.
I think she's going to spill the beans.
Well, you know who...
Now, rattle her cage a little.
I tell you who I think's going to be the other two out of this, the other two canaries.
McCabe.
Well, no, I think it's going to be... one of them could be Clapper. He is scared to death. You could tell he's just nervous as a cat on a hot
dog. Yeah, he is.
Bruce Orr and Nellie Orr, I think, are going to be the two canaries other than Baker out of this.
And, I like the show.
Well, they're going to connect Comey to it, to the dossier.
Well, see, that's it. That's the link to Comey, you know.
I hope they start talking.
Yeah, but now see, Durham, and I just heard again the other day that, you know, that he's just a law and order kind of guy. And he's, you know, he's strictly by the book, regardless who it is.
Right.
And, you know, he has the power to convene, which he's probably already, Dave, has convened a grand jury.
Oh, I think he has, too.
And he's got the power to subpoena, and he's probably got a stack
He's got the power to criminally charge.
Exactly. He can charge them, and... you know,
that inspector general, though, he's just going to use his report as a roadmap.
Yeah.
And it's going to call him before the grand jury. All the stuff that Horowitz has been digging up for the last year or two, he's going to just use that as a roadmap and start calling. It's going to be easy to investigate this because the work's been done.
It's been done.
A lot
of
people think it's going to take a long time. It's not.
Right.
It's not going to take a long time.
Right.
Because they already know what they've got statements from these people, they know what they did. All they got to do is call them before a grand jury. That's all they have to do is have the legal power to put teeth in it, and then they're going to start singing. Because Horowitz can't indict anyone. He can't arrest anyone. He can't charge anyone. All he can do is issue a report, and when the report comes out from Horowitz, then you're going to see the people start talking.
That's a notice to the public what's coming.
Yeah, they're talking out, like you said, Baker. Wait till the evidence does come out. They're all going to stand in line.
Yeah.
It all started from Obama because he hated Trump.
Yeah.
He hates Trump.
Well,
he's always hated Trump.
Oh, God, did he?
Well, there's evidence, Dave, that this stuff went to the top, that they wanted Obama, that Obama wanted to keep them posted.
Yeah, you can't have an investigation like that, intelligence investigation. What do they call it? Counterintelligence. You can't have that without the president's approval.
Right. And surveying American citizens.
So Obama had to know about it.
Right.
Not just an American citizen. A person running for president.
Right. Right. Yeah.
It's the biggest scandal in U.S. history.
It is.
This is never going to get settled until after Trump is out of office in 2024.
I don't know about that. I
don't think it can wait that long.
I think it's
going to take that long.
No, it won't. Like I said, Horowitz already, he's got the roadmap.
He's already laid down the groundwork.
Right. We know what happened. All we have to do is prove it.
Yeah. Know who the players are.
Once you get them singing, that's proof.
And I wonder if when the raids come, if CNN will be there to watch
people
get taken out in handcuffs.
Yeah. Right.
Once this all starts going down, it's going to go down pretty quick.
Yeah.
I think Dave's right.
So.
I think Dave's right on this. Because you got to strike while the iron's hot.
I don't know how true this is, but I heard a while back, several months ago, then somebody said, "Don't be surprised if you see on television U.S. Marshals going into the house and on the floor of the house and cuffing people and leading them out of the House of Representatives.
That'd be cool.
You know.
Oh, that would be hysterical.
Yeah.
Yeah, but the news media, the only flying ointment is the news media. They're not going to want to cover any of this because they think they're reporting.
Fox will.
They're saying a big conspiracy is going on. Yeah. That's all they're saying. It's a Fox News conspiracy.
Right. That's why more people tune in to Fox because they know they will actually broadcast the news instead of hiding it.
And they can't stop. And they can't stop the internet. And that's why they're trying their best. Kamala Harris and some of the rest of them. The AOC and that bunch trying to get Trump, trying to get Twitter to ban Trump off of Twitter, and get Zuckerberg to ban him off of Facebook, and that's what them trials was. That hearing was about when they had Zuckerberg up there, and they kept asking him, "Well, are you going to monitor these campaigns?" To see what, fact check these and this, that, and the other, and, you know, I mean, they just had him, they had him wrestled all over the place. I sent him a thing, a tweet, and I asked him, I said, now, you had a belly full of them, you ready to be a Republican now?
I know he's a lefty loony, but I really felt bad for him when they were questioning him. Because he was baffled. He didn't know what to say.
Yeah, because the questions were ridiculous.
They were.
Yeah. He was like a cornered animal. He didn't know what to say.
Exactly. I don't know. We don't take the races of people.
Yeah, that was crazy. That was stupid.
Yeah. That's exactly what I told him.
You want to know how many black people are on Facebook, and he had no idea how many.
We don't ask
him. I don't know.
And calling him racist for not knowing.
It'd be a federal crime if you ask people about that question.
And that just, you know, more dog and pony show, boys, is what that is. You know.
They just keep stomping on their own foot.
I guess Twitter's not allowing any political ads.
I don't know. I don't know, but now I know that, that's one of President Trump's main outlets. I
found who was against Trump being taken off of Twitter and Facebook?
Who's against
Elizabeth Warren.
She
said, no, you can't do that.
Right,
yeah. But the only thing that's ever come out of her
head. That stunned me when she said that.
I'll tell you guys a little secret that nobody knows. Nobody's talked about it, but by law, you know, you cannot edit or change an ad of a person running for office.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot change it. That means even if they cuss in it or even if they show nudity, you cannot change it. It's by law. It's written in the law.
Oh,
you can't
change it. I got to run for office. Nobody's done it, obviously.
They said, there's Paul. Turn it.
Yeah, it's just me talking.
No,
it's just Pornhub.
They'd have to put your literature in a brown bag.
What a station can do is refuse to run the ad, though.
Yeah, they can refuse.
They can refuse to run it, but they can't edit it or change it.
Well, they can't be held for liable either in a political campaign. So,
but see, that really bothers me.
Yeah.
You can lie about your opponent and not get in trouble about it.
Yeah, no, you can't.
Yeah, they do it all the time. Yeah. Democrats have been doing that for years.
Yeah.
I know.
Well, we never heard of fact-checking until the 90s.
Yeah.
But it's only certain facts are checked.
Only the conservative.
The Democratic ones.
Yeah, like the Washington Post with their, what's it, the Pinocchios there?
Yeah, Pinocchios. Yeah.
They do it all the time. It's just like that question that, on 60 Minutes, they asked Biden, what was it?
Refused him as a communion.
He said that was a personal
one. Oh, yeah. I was tickled. That tickled me.
They asked another question. Let me think of it. It was pretty interesting.
I don't know.
Was it about his son?
No, it was about Trump.
Oh.
And she assumed that Trump was lying in the question. Oh, yeah, she said, do you believe that the Russians, she goes, President Trump said that the Russians didn't interfere with this last election. And he goes, he's an idiot. That's what Biden said, he's an idiot.
Yeah.
But that's not what Trump said. Trump said that the Russians had no part in picking the president. They had no part. They didn't mess up any of the machines. The Russians had no effect on that.
Right.
He didn't say they weren't involved in trying to change the
Russians. They had their opinion, and they allowed one.
Right, right,
Yeah.
But Trump never said that. The reporter put words in his mouth that he never said.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, I tell you what. Joe Biden, he carries notes with him now. And you can tell when he don't have his notes because he sounds like an auctioneer trying to put two sentences together. And for the comedy value, it would be worth it for me just sit there and watch Trump just tear him a new one. So, and him trying, you know, and watch Biden try to debate him.
Can you imagine them two debating?
Oh, my God, it'd be beautiful.
Like I said, Hillary's probably the best debater they got in the whole Democratic team.
Yeah.
And he made mincemeat out of her.
Oh, yeah.
I'd like to see him debate Elizabeth Warren, too, though, just because I hate that crotchety old woman.
What Hillary's saying that debate in October, the one with Fox News did, she goes, "We're glad that you're not going to be president," or something. He goes, "If I were, you'd be in jail."
Exactly. And the place just went dead silent.
Yeah, he looked at her and said, "You'd be in jail," walked away. Well, I wish that had happened, but it didn't.
She ain't out of the woods yet, boys, because their investigation is going on right now.
That's why she's running for president. If she does, she wants to get ahead of the game here. Say they're picking on her.
Her best bet is to find her a place we don't have a diplomatic, well, we don't have a
extradition.
Yeah, and move there, and with or without old Slick Willie.
Yeah. She offered, you know what, if she got indicted or anything like that, and she felt it was coming, she'd off herself.
Probably, yeah.
What, she'd take the coward's way out?
I think so, I think she would.
I think she would give her a suicide vest and put that into action, see if it'll work.
Yeah, she'd just hire the people she's hired to kill everyone else to kill
her. Yeah, take Chelsea and the grandchildren and run down the tunnel.
Kill me, please.
But now, she ain't the only one. There's others that would probably do that when these indictments come down, if they see there's no way out of going to prison. But, you know, this email thing, I think that's on Dunham's list. So she's not
Durham.
Really
the to-do list.
Durham, Dunham, Mueller, Mueller, Mueller.
Durham, you're going to hear his name a lot coming up, that's for sure.
I'll learn it by the time this is over.
D-Y-H-A-M.
I never care. I get Durham and Dunham mixed up like Mueller and Mueller.
Oh, yeah.
I never got that one. It's Mueller.
Mueller.
That's the correct. They keep calling him Mueller, the press guy. His real correct name is Mueller.
Yeah, just think of Ferris Bueller.
Right.
There you go.
Bueller.
Hey, folks, this is Armed Radio. Let's sky on today. Special guests Jimmy Bell and Paul Daniels up there in New Hampshire. And give us a call, 1-800-508-5431, and we'll put you on the worldwide web here, folks. And
66 different countries.
66 different countries. When was the last time you was there? A
lot of them are where our troops are.
Yeah. Yes.
There was a judge that dismissed his lawsuit for the Washington Post, and there was 33 statements that the Washington Post made that they filed their suit on, and this judge, he dismissed the suit, but...
Are you talking about the Covington case?
Yeah.
I wanted to bring this up.
I never heard of it. What's going on?
They're giving him their...
About 40 miles from us.
Yeah, about 40 miles from us.
South. Well,
there's three statements that the judge has changed his mind on, and allowing Sandman the suit to go forward against the Washington Post.
Yep.
Yeah, what it was Phillips, ugly Indian dude.
Yeah.
He accused Sandman of blocking him on the steps of the Lincoln Memorial. Well, when you watch the video, he walked up to Sandman. And see, the Washington Post knew that. All the media knew that. They seen it, Dave. But they kept pushing the narrative and pushing the narrative that Sandman got in this poor American Indian's way, and he was just doing this ceremonial noise, bunch of racket to me. And he got in that boy's face, you know. So...
The Native American was the aggressor in that.
Yeah, he walked right up to him.
He did.
Yeah, the kid didn't approach him in any way.
Right. He didn't walk towards him and block him.
He ought to sue Phillips, too. He probably ain't got two pennies rubbed together, but he ought to sue him, too.
If I won the case, I'd say all they want is that drum that he was beating in great place.
Yeah, that's all I want. That's
all I want.
Yeah, you keep the stick you're banging on it with.
You
good at keeping that a PG, Jeff.
Hey, he done pretty good there. That could have went south real quick. But, you know, I mean, more power to the Sandmans. I hope they tear them a new one, boys, because them kids was... And it wasn't only the Sandman kid, but all these kids, you know, it had an impact on all these kids.
Well, it did, just representative of all the groups in the country for all the Catholic schools.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? They're not the only ones that are being discriminated.
Right.
And do you know what really amazes me about this? The judge reversed himself.
He did, yeah. Yeah. And there was 33 comments. And let's see, I got the number. They had them numbered, and it was like 11. Well, I know it's in here. They even numbered them. Yeah, 10, 11, and 33, the comments. Okay, now that's in their, you know, in the court documents. They had to number each statement. So on statement 10, statement 11, statement 33, and that's where they said that Nathan Phillips, that the kid blocked Nathan Phillips and wouldn't let him retreat. So, you know. But I think he'll win his suit, boys.
He didn't let him retreat. He was standing there when he approached him.
Yeah.
Nobody was holding him in any kind of threatening manner or anything.
Right. He had no route of escape.
Yeah, he could have walked around or kept on walking, but he decided to stop in front of this kid.
Well, what do you think about the media? Abu Bar al-Baghdadi was an austere religious scholar.
Yeah.
Father of three, too. Yeah, dies.
At least three.
Well, they're like 2,000 now.
Yeah, about 2,000 kids.
Jesus.
Yeah, right.
And the dog that went down there when it went off, he only got a slight... injury. They said he was backing his handlers in within hours.
Because God loves dogs.
Yeah.
Hates terrorists.
Oh, yeah. And you know, the guy they had planted in there, he was a Kurd that went in there and infiltrated that group.
Yes.
He stole a pair of his underwear. That's where they got the DNA from.
Well, Trump stuck up for the Kurds, and they gave him al-Baghdadi.
Yeah, sure did.
Underwear.
Yeah.
I've done that.
Yeah. So, yellow in the front, brown in the back.
I just wonder how he got his DNA to begin with.
Out of the underwear.
No.
Yeah.
You have to have something to compare it to.
Well, they dug it out of that pile of rubble, I guess.
Yeah. Oh, his head. Pick up a piece.
No, they had to have
his head intact.
They had to have his DNA in order to compare it to something.
Well, they did. They got his head.
No, before any of it happened, they had his... The DNA came from before the attack.
His underwear.
I know.
If I had his head, I would have shoved my fist in the hole and made a Muppet out of him.
The thing is, though, when they got the guy in smuggled into the complex to get his dirty underwear, they would have had to have something to compare it to already. So how would they have gotten that?
Baghdadi, because they were close behind, but never got him. So they took his clothes. They took anything that smelled like him.
Yeah, I know what you're saying, Dave. But
and just imagine that smell.
Yeah, they had it. Well, see, they had his kids. They took other kids, like 11 other kids. They rescued out of there.
Okay, yeah, they said they found a 1-year-old beaten to death.
Yeah, is that right?
Yeah.
Oh.
And, but anyway, that's where they got the other DNA, I'd say, from one of them kids that was still alive.
I mean, you can tell if somebody's a parent by DNA.
Yeah. But anyway, Kelly Conway.
We got about a minute.
All right, got about a minute. Kelly Conway, give him heck over that, boys. But now, Joe Biden, I tell you, that priest, it took a lot of guts for that priest to deny him, communion, and he done the right thing for a Catholic, you know, and because most of them wouldn't have done that. So kudos to that Catholic priest. Hey, thank you everybody for joining us tonight. And this is Les Skymo and the Dave Unscheduled, and with Jimmy and Paul, and pretty good show. Dave, you got anything?
I guess we'll do it again next week, won't we?
All right, we'll do it again next week. Jimmy and Paul, thank you guys for joining in.
Thanks to the troops.
Well, and thanks to the troops. And if I'm home, maybe I'll join you Friday night. I'm sending it back to you.